Good morning and welcome to BMS Toys TV. Today is a very special day where I'm not going to do any toys review. I'm actually going to talk about my Rift Tank. I know, BMS Toys TV, you guys must be thinking that it's all related to toys. You are right, it's related to my toys. And what happened is toys basically is something that people treasure because it's something very valuable to certain people, especially adults. The words toys, right, differ between children and adults. So for adult, toys means something that they treasure, they collect, and they love. So basically, for me personally, I have a lot of toys, and I guess Rift is one of my toys as well. So I've been in this riffing hobbies since about 18 years ago. I started off with a 2 feet tank, then it goes to 2 tanks, then it end up having to have this tank at the back. This tank is actually created about at least 15 years ago. Oh no, I think it's about 8 years ago, sorry. It's about 8 years ago. So, eventually along the way, there's a lot of things happen. The tank become super dirty when I don't take care of it. A lot of coral die, a lot of fish die. And end of the day, the whole tank become green for the past 2 years when my boys are born. I don't know, for the past few years when my boys are born, because there's basically no time for it. So my boys are now a bit more grow up. They are about 6 years old now this year. So I've actually restarted this hobby back. Not restarted, the thing is all there. But at that point of time, the tank is in a very bad condition and I don't really reset it. I actually continue from where I left it off. So at the point when I started off again this tank, right, it has high PO4, high NO3, everything is high, everything is bad. The only two survival in the tank until now is basically the two clownfish. So I've restarted 2 years ago. I've been through a lot. Maybe I can share a lot, share some of my experience with you guys on what I did to improve all the parameters in the tank. You know, for reefing, it's not about how you keep your corals or how you keep your fish. Basically, or typically, it's about how you keep your water. How to make sure the water parameters is good for your fish and coral to survive. And about a year ago, I also started my SPS collections. I only started with LPS for the past few years. And I only started like with SPS for like about a year ago. And it's, as you can see from the back, right, it's actually surviving. I mean, since this past 1 year, any SPS that I put inside, right, it is actually surviving and it's actually working very well. So today, this is the first video on the reefing, which is also part of my toy site. So I considered putting this into my BMS Toys TV YouTube channels. So I'll be sharing with you guys just an introductory of my tank, just a glance through, and maybe later if the response is okay or not really based on the response, I mean based on my time. If I have time, right, I will start to talk about the devices that I have. So if you see, I have quite a fair bit of devices over here and there, and at the bottoms over here, as you can see, is a big system behind the scene. So I'll be sharing with you guys on that later, and partially how I actually combat all the issues that I have high NO4 until it's not readable by Sutherford's tester. It's very bad when I started off. So this very bad until now, when I have the sort of my perfect parameter, it takes about 9 months. So without further ado, let's start the tour. Thank you.
Thank you.